of church in the Anglican, when we be singing, we say, oh, amen. So I'm approaching for that. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to today's service.
Good morning.
We're supposed to be the spring season, but it's then a bit cold. Maybe tomorrow things will change. Yeah, but it's a lovely weather. We can't just jump into the spring. Welcome to today's service, all of you. Even to those who are following us online, please feel welcome to worship with us this morning. This morning we are celebrating the birthday of the Homo Father. Yeah, you know I'm all this. But we are celebrating the birthday of the Homo Father. There's still some committee members who asked us to keep them in our prayers. And those are Shelly and Ferguson, Lydia Manindi, Esther Homu, Heaven Hedges, Mahamad's family, Gaga's family, and Shika's family. And even other families whom their names may not be written on here on the pulpit yet. But you know that whenever you pray, I ask you that you pray for them also. Just bring them to God. God already knows what they are seeking in their prayer. Just bring them to God. Amen.
Amen.
Shall we pray? Heavenly Lord, we thank you for this beautiful day, Lord. And then let everything that is breath praise your name. For Lord, you are always good to us. The first gift that you give us to each and every one of us every morning when we wake up is a breath into our life. So that, Lord, we can come and live in this new day that you've given to us. Therefore, Lord, we have no reason of not to praise you. Because there's no one who can give life apart from you. The birth of the sun, even the flowers which are springing up now as we go to the new season, they also got to have a way to thank you. For Lord, you are always wonderful into our lives. You always do wonders into our lives. Lord God, we bring to those to you, those who have asked us to keep them in our prayers. And that, Lord, you know their pain. We ask you, Lord, that be with them and deliver them, Lord. As for us who are here this morning, give us a joyous heart, Lord, to sing out to you. For, Lord, you are our God and Redeemer. In Christ Jesus, Lord, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
My dear sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the service of the Lord.
And blessed be God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Blessed be his name, now and
forever. Good morning.
Good morning.
God is good.
All the time. God is good.
It is nice to be here.
Amen.
As we are going into time of praise and worship, just want us to take our focus this morning and look up to the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Let's just take a moment and think of all the things that God has done since the beginning of this year up until now. The Lord of God says, when praise goes up, his glory comes down.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we're going to go into a time of praise and worship. I'm going to ask that you help me with the singing of the song All to Jesus as we continue praising him.
All to Jesus.
All to thee I fear.
till today they have never abandoned us. Hence we are saying this morning we surrender it all to you. All the things that are troubling us in this world, in this life, we bring them all to you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
We may leave or sit to continue. Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, hear the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and with you magnify your name through Christ our Lord. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Jesus said, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the first and the great commandment. And the second is like it. You shall love the Lord your God with... You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments depend all the law and the prophets. Let us confess our sins, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with our neighbor. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, impenitently confess that we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone. For the sake of your Son, Christ our Lord, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life to the glory of your name.
Almighty God, who forgave all those who repent, have mercy on you. Pardon your sins and set you free from them. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness and keep you into eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Join together as we play the collect of Sophie Gray. As we say together,
Sing, Lord, you call your servants to pray to establish the visible presence of the Indian Church in Southern Africa. Grant that we may follow their example and continue to serve.
First reading is taken from the book of 1 Corinthians, reading from chapter 3, verses 1 to 9. Don't be surprised because I've got permission to read it from the Message this morning, so it's going to be a slightly different version. Paul is writing to the people in Corinthians who are having struggles and difficulties in the church. But for right now, friends, I'm completely frustrated by your unspiritual dealings with each other. raising up infants in relation to Christ, capable of nothing much more than nursing at the breast. Well then, I'll nurse you, since you don't seem capable of anything more. As long as you grab what makes you feel good or makes you look important, are you really much different than a babe at the breast, content only when everything is going your way? When one of you says, I'm on poor south, and another says, I'm for Apollos, aren't you being totally infantile? Who do you think Paul is anyway, or Apollos? For that matter, servants, both of us, servants who wait upon you as you gradually learn to entrust your lives to our mutual master. We carried out our servant assignment. I planted the seed, Apollos took the plants, but God made you grow. It's not the one who plants or the one who waters who is at the center of this process, but God who makes things grow. Planting and watering are menial servant jobs at minimum wages. What makes them worth doing is the God we are serving. You happen to be God's field in which we are working. Here ends the first lesson.
Thanks.
Our printed psalm for this morning, Psalm 62, and for those who are following the reading and prayer book, can be found on page 677, Psalm 62. I'll read the odd verses and invite you to respond to the even verses. My soul waits in silence for God, for from him comes my salvation. How long will you all plot against a man to destroy him, as though he were a living fence or a battling wall? Nevertheless, my soul wait in silence for God, for from him comes my hope.
You only is my rock and my salvation. My soul trusts on the shadow.
In God is my deliverance and my dwelling. God is my strong rock and my shelter.
Oh,
chapter 4, reading from verse 38.
Glory to Christ.
Jesus left the synagogue and went to the home of Simon. Now Simon's mother-in-law was suffering from a high fever, and they asked Jesus to help her. So he bent over her and rebuked the fever, and it left her. She got up at once and began to wait on them. At sunset, the people brought to Jesus all who had various kinds of sickness, and laid his hands on each one. He healed them. Moreover, demons came out of many people, shouting, "You are the Son of God." But he rebuked them and would not allow them to speak, because they knew he was the Messiah. At daybreak, Jesus went out to a solitary place. The people were looking for him, and when they came to where he was, they tried to keep him from leaving. But he said, "I must proclaim the good news of the kingdom of God to other towns also, because this is what I was sent." And he kept on preaching in the synagogues of Judea. This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to Christ, our Lord.
And make you healthy again. It's all about it. You go to supermarket somewhere, Woolworths, and you go and buy with 160 you can get 2 chickens. So you bring them the money, you don't get the money back. They bring you the product. So you bring something, you get something. But today, let me speak about the policemen above all the police. The security above all securities in the world. The king above all kings. The one man who's the best out of all. The best doctor that no one can provide. Best doctors above all doctors. The only God sent, Son of Man. From the Gospel of Luke, chapter 4, where we have read, Christ was full of the Holy Spirit. But then we started back then. It was right after he got baptized by John the Baptist. And the Holy Spirit took him to the wilderness, where he was tested and all that for 40 days. And after he finished that 40 days, fasting and praying and getting tested, but he passed that and he came. The first thing that he did, he continued healing people, lepers, all kinds of things. He was, and on top of that, he was rejected in Nazareth. Since chapter 4, you can read the whole chapter. He was rejected in Nazareth. Imagine coming back from when you haven't eaten, you haven't had get rejected from your own time. But he didn't matter. He continued preaching the way of God. He went and continued to heal people. What we have read, because people have seen that this Christ is incredible. Someone was told that in Bethsaida, where someone was told, said, "Your mother-in-law, she's sick with high fever." It's not just fever that we know, it is called high fever. So, he went to Simon's home and listen to what he did. He knelt down. He knelt. Ukuna. Bent over to mother-in-law of Simon. After he knelt, he touched her. Well, after touching her, he rebuked the high fever. And instantly, it left her, and she was healed. People were there because they kept on following him to wherever he was going. People were there. And they realized, what did he actually did? And they started to say, you know what? I've got a sick mother, I've got a sick child, they started praying in the church. And he laid hands. The lame were brought. The blind were brought, everyone, those who were possessed by demons, and the demons were about to speak and say, "Hey, this is Son of Man," and he rebuked them before he even finished. He rebuked them. And he began to heal so many people on that day. What a humble servant Jesus was. Knelt, touched, and rebuked. But today, I want to talk about bringing it to Jesus. He is here, the Son of Man, and saying to you, bring it to me. It doesn't matter what it is, but bring it to me, and I shall deal with it. The problem here in Akore, we want to deal with things on our own. And when things get attacking us or situations affecting us, we sit and feel sympathy to ourselves and say, what can I do? You have solution. Bring it to Jesus. He's the one who can free you from that. Could be any kind of disease of loved one, or you could be ill, you are in yourself. Anything. Don't say, this one, Christ can't do it. Who are you? This is Christ particular. He is the doctor of all doctors. He is the white man sent on this earth, and he is here in my body.
The problem is we do not bring it to Jesus. We sit with things. And the wrong thing that we do, we speak to our neighbors, our friends, they can't help us. There is a doctor, there is a psychologist, there is a counselor. Jesus Christ said, bring it to me. Bring it to me. I want it. Do not sit with it. Could be family challenges, marriage, or anything. It doesn't matter. Relationship, marriage, your children, bring it to Jesus. He said, bring it to me. Bring it to me. He's willing to negotiate. You know, sometimes we should not stop and one thing. We should explore more. Our problem is we sometimes unable to accept other things in life. You know, the fact that I bought a movie, Jenny Blank, and said, oh, where did you get that? They look nice, but, you know, those kind of things. We are unable to. It's kind of a jealousy. It's not normal. Bring it to Jesus, life. Bring it to Jesus. He wants to deal with it. Then you can freely just say, hey, wow, we are huge. Where did you buy? I wish I can have it today. Hey, did you see a handbag? I think I saw it everywhere. That doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Stop with that jealousy. You know, sometimes when we just speak lies. And it's a norm to us. We don't even realize that it's not a normal life. Bring it to Jesus and say, God, I'm unable to live a truthful life. I'm just a gossip about it. You know, when I just have that cup of coffee and mama, and you know, I just become. People of God, it is not normal. Bring it to Jesus. He's going to free us from that. Even when we are happy, it doesn't matter. You know, there's in Second Thessalonians, it says, pray at all times. Doesn't matter whether you're happy, sad, or what. Pray at all times. In all circumstances. Never stop praying. So even when we are happy, we should talk to God and say, God, I am happy. I am joyful. Thank you for this. And may God help me to keep this joyful life. But people will be surprised, hey, he's forever here, but it doesn't matter. Keep praying to God. Keep praying. The question may be, how do I bring it to Jesus? How do I bring it to Jesus? It is through faith. You need to believe in God fully soon. Because he brought his only son to free us so that we can bring it to him. So you need to believe in God fully so. Have that faith and never doubt that this is Christ, son of man. He is here. If you start having doubt, you will pray, but your prayer will not be answered. The second thing that you can do to bring it to Jesus is through prayer. There's no way you can just keep on crying, and hey, I'm going away, I don't even have food, I don't have something to wear, and they bring into my house great times. Pray to God. Pray to God. If you keep telling me, I'll share, and pass. Tomorrow I find, hey, share and pass. So bring it to Jesus through prayer. Right, God, this time I'm praying that this shall stop in the name of Jesus. This disease shall never be a problem to me. Lord God, I'm praying that this family shall not fall apart. Bring it with prayer. And once you believe and have faith, and you pray, your prayers will be answered. You remember the story of Hannah? She prayed. She said, God, I'm tired of not having a baby. And Lord God, just give me one, and I will bring it back to you. And God answered her. You remember the story of Daniel? He prayed when he was going into the den of lions. And God saved him from hungry lions. So we can do it too. Have that faith and pray at all times. Never stop praying. So that is how we bring it to Christ. Let us then remember. Amen.
Amen.
Almighty God,
sorrow, need or sickness. Lord, may your loving hand direct our steps as we go out into the world now and always. May the love of the Father, the tenderness of the Son, and the presence of the Holy Spirit gladden our hearts and bring peace to our souls at all times. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Walk on in the light, divide us all.
which ate and lived and lived and lived, for us becomes the bread of life.
Blessed is the Lord forever.
Blessed are you, the God of all creation. Through your goodness and this wine to offer, from the divine work of human beings, for us becomes the cup of salvation.
Blessed be the Lord forever.
We continue with the fourth Eucharistic prayer on page 124. My dear sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give you thanks and praise.
We give you thanks and praise, Almighty God, through your blessed Son Jesus Christ, our Savior and Redeemer. He is the living bread, through whom you have created all things. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took the flesh of the Virgin Mary and shed our human nature. He lived and died as one of us to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. In fulfillment of your will, he stretched us his hand in suffering to bring relief to those who place their hope in you. And so, he won for you a holy people. He chose to bear our grief and sorrows and to give up his life on the cross, that he may shatter the chains, of the evil one and banish the darkness of sin and death. By his resurrection, he brings us into the light of your presence. Now, with all creation, we raise our voices to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of our hands, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
Holy and gracious God, accept our praise through your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ. Hope the night that you were given over to suffering and death, took bread and gave you thanks. And gave you, saying, take and eat, this is my body, which is broken for you.
Oh, come let us adore.
As we gather to ask, I want to pray the Lord's prayer
dear sisters and brothers, this is the Lord, for He is gracious.
His name is awesome.
Together we say, Father Almighty, we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice. In Jesus Christ, our Lord, send us out into the world in the power of the Holy Spirit
to lead the way to your grace and glory.
Again, say, God bless us.
And we pray for
that God would ever, when the evil spirit might think of coming back to attack them, to take it, gracious God, that it has been gained access. We pray for this gracious spirit, that God, we bless them now and send the Holy Spirit at all times to protect them. And Lord, we ask you that be with the ordinance, to be with and Darius, whatever we understand through this garden, may they be filled by your Holy Spirit, so that Lord, they may accomplish the studies that they are studying at the moment. In Christ Jesus, Lord, we bless the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, who lives and who never sleeps at any time, who is our Lord and Redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
May I call upon the three of them so that we can get these gadgets in front of you as a witness. And take what belongs to the Lord and things that are meant behind. So let us all start with the Puno contribution. I think it's Puno only. Oh, there's also God's Day, where we have the tickets in the office for God's Day. Very soon they'll be sold by the fundraising committee, the tickets and the t-shirts for God's Day. So the ticket for the ticket for the gala dinner for God is $250 for the gala dinner for the golf day. The golf day will be on the 28th of October. So go and spread the message to the golfers who you know to participate on the golf. The fans are not going anywhere else. The fans are coming to church to assist us at the Warden site on Sunday that this nice old building is really in need of maintenance and it needs lots of money so that we can keep it up to standard. So we need to go and participate and invite others also to participate in all the fundraisings that the church is offering. I thank you. Oh, the last one is regarding pledge or tithes. We went back to online conferring of your pledges and tithes, and the statements have been sent to your income profile. We sent out the message or the instruction on how to get an access to my income profile so that you can view your giving. For just in case you want to know the amount which you are behind with, or in case you want to see if you are up to date with your giving unto the Lord, yes, you may log in and go to read there online. If you can't, the administrator is always available, I'm always available to assist you with logging in to the system and you can view it on your own. It has a huge privacy, so no one else can view your giving apart from you alone. So if you want to view your giving, please go and log into the online and confirm your giving there. Thank you. Continue to have a blessed week and enjoy the spring day tomorrow. Go on our most old days where we used to have a bucket of water for the spring day. But the weather, maybe the weather tomorrow will permit us to splash each other with water. But go and enjoy.